number system. So usually you count any set of objects like this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this type of numbers you call it as the natural numbers or counting numbers. So you count like this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and so on. So you call it as natural numbers or counting numbers. Okay, next. So the natural numbers, you divide it into two types. One is the prime numbers and one more is a composite number. So natural numbers, you divide it into two types. One is a prime number and one more is a composite number. So prime number is a number, it is greater than 1. So prime number is a number greater than 1, and as the only factors 1 and number itself. As the only factors 1 and the number itself. Example 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, 19. So like this you get so on. So example you take 3. So 3 can written as 3 into 1. There is only two factors. One is a number itself and is a 1. So one is a number itself and 1. So you take 2 into 1. So 5, 5 into 1. There is no other possibilities. Okay, next. So prime number is a number greater than 1 and has the only factors 1 and the number itself. So next, composite numbers. Composite number is a number greater than 1. Composite number is a number greater than 1 and it has a more than 2 factors. It has a more than 2 factors. So prime number has a only 2 factors, 1 and the number itself. So it is more than 2 factors. Example 4, 6, 9, 8 and so on. So 9 is also prime composite number, 9, 12, 15. So take example 4. So 4 can written as 4 into 1 and one more chance you have 2 into 2. So total you have 3 factors. One is 4, one is 1 and one more is 2. So total you have 3 factors. Therefore it is a composite number. So composite number is a number greater than 1 and it has a more than 2 factors. So next set after natural numbers, you have whole numbers. So 0 together with natural numbers are called whole numbers. 0 together with natural numbers are called whole numbers. You see that 1, 2, 3, 4, it is natural numbers. 1, 2, 3, 4 is a natural number, so on. So 0, when you add it, you get 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So this set you call it as the whole number. So inclusion of 0. So next, after whole number, you have integers. After whole number, you have integers. You see that 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is a set of whole numbers. From here to here is a set of whole numbers. And you have extra added is minus 1, negative numbers, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, so on. So this is a left side of the number line. So this is a right side of the number line. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this you call it as positive integers. So 1, 2, 3. So this one you call it as the positive integers. So minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. So this one you call it as the negative integers. 0. So this is a middle 0. So 0 neither positive nor negative. 0 has a neither positive nor negative. So after integers you have rational numbers. So a rational number is a number that can be written in the form of p by q, where p and q are integers and q not equal to 0. So a rational number is a number that can be written in the form of p by q, where p and q are integers and q not equal to 0. So this is a simple definition for rational number. The set q denotes the rational number set. So rational number is equal to a set p by q, where p comma q belongs to z, means integer, and q not equal to 0. So next, example for rational numbers. All the fractions are example for rational numbers. All the fractions are example for rational numbers. 1 by 9. So it is in the form of p by q. 7. 7 can written as 7 by 1. So now it is in the form of p by q. Root 16. So root 16 is equal to 4. So root 16 is equal to 4, and 4 can written as 4 by 1. So it is in the form of P by Q. So 0.5, you know that it is a half, 1 by 2. So when you convert it to fraction, so it is 1 by 2. 0.33, so when it is converted to fractions, so that is in the form of P by Q, so on. So this is the set of rational numbers. So rational numbers are denoted with the letters Q, and integers you denoted with the letter Z, and whole numbers you denoted with the set W and N for natural numbers. So next, after rational numbers, you have irrational number. An irrational number is a number that cannot be written in the form of P by Q. So you cannot return, in the form of P by Q, where P and Q are integers and Q not equal to 0. So irrational number is a number you can't write in the form of a P by Q, where P and Q are integers. Example, pi. So one value is pi. So example is pi, and the second one root 5, root 11. So all you get the decimals. So root 5, root 11. So okay, next point. If the decimal form of a number stops or repeats, so one more. So now you how you differentiate between rational and irrational. Okay, if the decimal form of a number stops, means terminates, or repeats, means continuous repeats, that number is rational numbers. So one is terminates and recurring, that number you call it as the rational. So second, if the decimal form of a number does not stop means you get a continuous numbers after decimal, and does not repeat, the number is irrational. So now you show that some example, then you understood very well. So example of rational numbers, first you see that example of rational numbers. So first I given 3 by 8 equal to 0.375. so here stops the decimal numbers, here stops 0.375, so terminates and stops, so therefore it is rational numbers. The decimal expansion of a rational number terminates. So second, 2 by 15, so the decimal expansion of 2 by 15 is equal to 0.13333333. so there is a continuous repetition of 3333, so equal to 0.13 bar. So you have continuous repeating or recurring. So that type of number is also a rational number. So you have continuous 3333 repetitions. If you have that type of numbers, you call it as a rational numbers. So next, one more example, you see that 11 by 13. So 0.846153. That means 846153 will repeats. So 8461 53 8461 53 8461 53, so continuous repeating of 8461 53, so that is also a rational number. So these are all example for rational number. So one it is terminates, and one more is continuous repeating 3333, one more it is repeating of 8461. So certain pattern you repeats in the same manner, so that is also a rational number. So next, now you see that example for irrational number. So first one, pi. The value of pi is 3.14159265. So here you see that it does not stop. Here also it is does not stop, but it is repeating. So you see that 3.14159265 and some different numbers you get, but it is a does not stop and does not repeat. So does not stop and does not repeats, if you get, then it is irrational number. So one is 3.14, it is nearly equal to 3.14. in some problems you take the value 3.14, you can't take this big number. So next, root 2. The value of root 2 is equal to 1.41421352, so on. So it is also, it does not repeat and does not stop also, the nearly equal to 1.41. so like that root 3 you get. So next, root 7, root 11. So root 9 is not a irrational. Root 9 equal to 3. So this it is a rational. It is a rational. So root 10 irrational. Root 10 is irrational. So like this. Okay. Okay, next, real numbers. So rational numbers, real numbers are nothing but is a union of rational and irrational numbers. So real numbers are nothing but is a union of rational numbers and irrational numbers. Is a set of rational and irrational together, you call it as the real number. So one last sketch I given. So first you have counting numbers n. How do you count? 1 2 3 4 5. So after, so this is n. When you together with 0, when you add 0, then it is whole numbers. Then it is a whole numbers. When you add negatives, -1 -2 -3, so then it is integers. Then it is a integers. You have negative numbers. So when it is added fractions or some p by q forms, that is 1 by 2 1 by 3, so that type of numbers you call it as a rational numbers. That you call it as a rational numbers, q, denoted with q. After that, one more set you have irrational number. So that is not in the form of p by q. So that is not in the form of p by q. That is not in the form of p by q. So example, root 2, root 3, pi. So this together you call it as a reals. This together you call it as a real numbers. Okay, now we have to some application. So state whether the following statements are true or false. Give reason for your answers. So every natural number is a whole number. So every natural number is a whole number. So every natural number is a whole number. True. Since 0 together with the natural numbers are whole numbers. 0 together with the natural numbers are whole numbers. You know that whole number set is bigger one. Whole number set is bigger one. It contains 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, so on. So this is a natural number. So every natural number in the set of whole numbers. So next, every integer is a whole number. Every integer is a whole number. False. Since integer set is 0, plus or minus 1, so plus or minus 2, plus or minus 3, plus or minus 4, so on. So whole numbers are 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So there is no negative numbers in the whole number set. Therefore, it is false. So every integer is not in the set of whole number. So whole number does not have a negative integers. So next, third one. Every rational number is a whole number. Every rational number is a whole number. So clearly you know that rational number set is too big and a whole number set is small. False. Since rational numbers 2 by 5, 1 by 2 are not in the set of whole number. So 1 by 2, 1, 2 by 5 are not there in the set of whole numbers. Whole numbers are 1, 2, 3. So this is a whole number set. So every irrational number is a real number. It's true. Since real number is a set of rational number and irrational number. So real number is a union of rational and irrational number. Therefore, every irrational number is there in the set of real number. So next, every point on the number line is of the form root m, where m is a natural number. Every point on the number line is of the form root m, where m is a natural number. False. Since the negative number as well as the zero on the number line cannot be expressed in the square root of the naturals. So you see that the negative numbers of square root, so square root of minus 1, so this will give imaginary numbers. So this topic not you have. So minus 1, so it is not there in the set of that is not in the number line. So false. Since negative numbers as well as 0 on the number line cannot be expressed as a square root of naturals. Okay, next. Every real number is an irrational number. So every real number is an irrational number. False. Since 1 by 5, 3 by 4 is not an irrational number. So irrational numbers are root 2, root 3, root 5 and pi are irrational numbers. So 5, 1 by 5, 3 by 4 and 1, 2, 3, they are not in the set of irrational numbers. So that is false. Every real number is an irrational number. Okay. Are the square root of all positive integer is irrational, or the square root of all positive integer is irrational. If not, give an example of the square root of a number that is a rational number. See, no. So, our square root of all positive integer is irrational. No. Since root 4 equal to 2, so this is a rational. Root 4 is equal to 2, root 9, root 16, all are perfect squares. Root 4, root 9, root 16, root 25, root 36, root 49. So you get whole numbers are rationals. So you get root 2, root 3, root 6, root 10, all are irrational numbers. The square root of every positive integer is an irrational, is not an irrational number. Therefore, the square root of every positive integer is not an irrational number. Okay, next. If 0 is a rational number, can you write in the form P by Q, where P and Q are integer? 0 can be written in the form of 0 by 1, 0 by 2, 0 by 3, 0 by 4, so on. And 0 by minus 1 in negatives also, 0 by minus 2, minus 3, 0 by minus 4, and so on. So 0 can be written in the form of P by Q. So where P and Q are integers, 0 is also integer, 1 is also integer, 2, 3, 4, all are integers, and Q not equal to 0. Therefore, 0 is a rational number. 0 is a rational number. So it can be written in the form of P by Q, and these are all the types: 0, 1, 0, 0 by 2, 0 by 3, 0 by 4. And 0 by minus 1 is also, you can write minus 2, 0 by minus 3, 0 by minus 4, so on. So find 6 rational number between 3 and 4. So find 6 rational number between 3 and 4. We know that 3 can written as 3 by 1 and 4 can written as 4 by 1. You know that 3 can written as 3 by 1 and 4 can written as 4 by 1. So this is in the form of rational number P by Q. So 4 can written as 4 by 1. So we have to multiply and divided by 7. So we have to multiply and divided by 7. So 3 by 1 equal to 7. 3 by 1 into 7 by 7. And 4 by 1 into 7 by 7. Since you want 6 rational number, so you multiply and divided with 7. So when you want 10, so we want to multiply and divided by 11. So one more. So you get 3 sevens are 21 by 7, 4 sevens are 28 by 7. The 6 rational numbers between 3 and 4, after 21 you have 22 by 7, so 23 by 7, 24 by 7, 25 by 7, 26 by 7, and 27 by 7. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So if you want 6 rational numbers, you multiply and divide it by 7. You want 12 rational number, you multiply and divide it by 13. So then you get that type of numbers. Okay, next. Find 5 rational number between 3 by 5 and 4 by 5. So you want 5 rational numbers between 3 by 5 and 4 by 5. So we know that 3 by 5 can written as 3 by 5. So into 6 divided by 6. So 3 by 5 into 6 divided by 6, 4 by 5 into 6 divided by 6, you get 3 6 are 18, 5 6 are 30, and 4 6 are 24, 5 6 are 30. So you have the common denominator. So the 5 rational numbers between 3 by 5 and 4 by 5 are, after 18 you have 19 by 30, 20 by 30, 21 by 30, 22 by 30, and 23 by 30. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You want 5 means you have to multiply and divide by 6. Okay. Show how root 2 can be represented on the number line. So first you draw one number line. Take that. So 1 inch is 1 unit and 2. So 1, 2. So and this is 1 unit, so up to here it is 2 units. So 1, 2 units. So now you find root 2 in number line. So 1 unit. So first we have to construct 90 degree here. First you have to construct 90 degree. How do you construct 90 degree? You have to keep the compass like this. The same distance you have to take it. Okay, you have to cut it like this. and the first cut it is 60 and the second cut it is 120. Okay, so the second cut it 120, you see that it is 120. So the middle of this 120 and 60 you get 90. Okay, like this. So this is a 90. You have to join this one, we have to join this one. So and take this same 1 unit. So you take this one 1 unit and cut it here. So cut it here like this, we have to cut it like this. So this is the 1 unit. So join this one, so join this one. So the length from here to here, it is root 2. The length from here to here, it is root 2. So from here to here, it is a root 2. So same line you cut like this. So length from here to here, it is root 2. So take it in compass. So this is a root 2 now. So the same distance you cut it here now. So this is the value is root 2. So I write root 2 here. So this is a root 2. So understood, this is the number line. So how do you construct root 2 in number line? So by the Pythagoras theorem, you have the explanation now. OK square. So this is a, so first I tell the definition of Pythagoras theorem. In a right triangle, so in a right triangle, so Pythagoras theorem tells, in a right triangle, so this is one right triangle, the square of the hypotenuse, so the square of the hypotenuse, so I write here, the square of the hypotenuse is equal to the sum of the squares of the other two sides. The sum of the OA square and OK square, AK square, the sum of the squares of the other two sides. So by the Pythagoras theorem, OK square, it is hypotenuse square is equal to OA square plus AK square. So OA square, it is 1 square. So and it is also 1 square, 1 square plus 1, 1 square is 1, 1 square is 1. So that is 1 plus 1, you get 2. So OK square, so OK equal to root 2. So you get OK square, you get 2. So that means OK is root 2. OK is equal to root 2. Square root on both sides if you take. So this square root will cancel with square root. You get OK is equal to square. OK equal to root 2. So OK equal to root 2 means the same value, take it here in the compass. You see that the same value you have from here to here. So this is OK, is the same value you have. So this is also root 2 units. So next, locate root 3 on the number line. Locate root 3 on the number line. So first you construct root 2. So for this one, first you construct root 2. So you see that this is 1 unit, so this one is 1 unit, so 2 units. So first you construct 90 degree using the compass. So construct 90 degree like this. So first cut it is the same distance you take, this is 60 degree. So next it is 120. So next you have 120 you have. So 120 this one. So middle of this one is a 90. So if you take like this, it is a 90. So join this one. So and join this one, you get it is root 2. So root 2 you have now. So this line is root 2. And take 1 unit from this one. So 1 unit you have. So 1 unit. So first you construct 90 degree here. First you construct 90 degree. 1. First cut is 60. First cut it is 60. Second cut it is 120. So middle of 60 and 120 you get 90. So this is a 120. Join this one and the same 1 unit you take from this one. So this is 1 unit and you kept here and cut it like this. So this is a root 3. When you join this one, the value is root 3. And take the same length and cut it here, the value in the number line, so B. So from O to B it is root 3. So by the Pythagoras theorem, so now it is a right angle triangle. So this is now right angle triangle. You know that this is right triangle. So with the 90 degree here. So OK square, so this is the hypotenuse. OK square is equal to OC square plus CK square. OC square plus CK square, Pythagoras theorem. So the value of OC square is root 2, so whole square, root 2 whole square. ck square is 1 square. So root 2, 2 and square root cancels. So 2 and square root cancels. So value of root 2 and square root cancels. 1 square is 1. So 2 plus 1, it is 3. So ok square is equal to 3. So ok means when you take the square root on both sides. So this square root is cancelled with this. So ok equal to root 3. So ok equal to root 3 means the same length you take it from here to here. So then OB is also root 3. So next you want to take root 5. Root 5. So clearly you know that root 5 is more than root 4. So the value of root 4 equal to, you know that it is 2. So root 1 is equal to 1. So root 4 is equal to 2. So root 5, it is more than 2. Root 5 is more than 2. So you take 2 units and construct 90 degree using the compass. So you have to take 2 units and construct 90 degree like this. So first you take one curve, arc, and first cut it is 60. The next cut is 120. So the middle of 120 and 60 you get 90. So this is a 90 and take 1 unit. So this is the 1 unit from here to here and cut it here. So join this one. This is a root 5. So when you construct here, that is root 2. When you construct here now, that you get root 5 in the point 2. When you construct in the point 2. So this is 0, 1, 2. So in the case of root 2, you construct in the 1, first point 1. So then you get root 2. So here also you take it 1 and you take 2 times. So 1 here, 1 is here, then you get root 3. So now you see that root 5, you take it from 2 because it is a root 4. Root 4 more than root 4. So 1 unit you take root 5. So by the Pythagoras theorem, so hypotenuse, OK square is equal to OA square plus AK square. So OA square, 2 units, 2 square plus AK square is 1. So 1 square. So 2 square is equal to 4 plus 1. So that is OK square, you get 5. So OK equal to, when you take square root on both sides, so square root and square get cancels. OK equal to root 5. OK equal to root 5. I show that root 7 on the number line. Now I show that root 7 on the number line. So clearly you know that. So root 7 lies in between. So root 7 is lies in between root 4 and root 9. So root 4 is equal to 2. So less than or equal to root 7. Less than or equal to root 9 is 3. So root 7 is lies between. Root 7 is lies between 2 and 3. So in point 2 we have to construct 90 degree. In point 2 we have to construct 90 degree. First take an arc. The same distance or the same curve you cut once. So the from now it is 60 degree from here to here. So next it is one more cut if you take. So it is 120 degrees. So the intersection of 60 degrees and 120 degrees, it is 90 degrees. So join this one. So join this one from here to here. So it is 90 degree. So take one unit. Take one unit. So this one is one unit, or the same distance from here to here, it is also one unit. So cut here. So this one is a one unit. So join 0 to here. So join 0 to here. So this line is root 5. So this line is root 5. The line is root 5. So this point you name it as C. So in the point C, now we have to construct one more time 90 degree. So okay, take an arc. The first arc is a 60 degrees. When you join here to here, it is 60. And one more time if you draw this, so you get 120. So So the middle of 60 and or the intersection of 60 and 120, you get 90 degree. So join from here to here. So it is 90 degrees. So take 1 unit now. So it is 1 unit only. So you check it once it is 1 unit. So 1 unit, cut it here. So the same line you get. So join. So this line is root 6. Now we have to construct. So this point you read it as a B. This point is read it as B. In the point B, now one more time you have to construct 90 degrees. So take an arc like this. The first 60, next 120 is the middle of 60 or the intersection of 60 and 120. You get 90 degrees. Join this one. Okay, this is 90 degree. Okay, take 1 unit. So this is 1 unit. From here to here it is 1 unit. So cut it here. The same line you get it. So join this one. So this one itself is a root 7 and name it A. So this one is root 7. And the same point. Okay, so we have to do like this. Okay, so from, so I take somewhat upside. So this point I take it as X. So this point is X. So from here to here, root 7. So this is root 7. Okay, so if I join like this curve, so this is a root 6. So when it is joined here, so root 5 is here almost. So like this. So this is the construction of root 7 on the number line. Okay, next, write the following in the decimal form and say what kind of decimal expansion and what kind of decimal expansion each has. First one, 36 by 100. So we have to divide 36 by 100. So clearly it is a proper fraction. So the answer is in between 0 and 1. So the decimal expansion of 36 by 100 is 0.36 and the remainder is 0. And the remainder is 0 and it is terminating. There is no repetition. Therefore, it has a terminating decimal expansion and it is in the form of P by Q. Therefore, it is a rational number. So 1 by 11. So the decimal expansion of 1 by 11 you get 0.09090909 continuously repeating. Therefore 0.09 bar. Okay, the remainder always you get the remainder 1. Okay, you get the remainder 1 and 9. So it has a non-terminating and a recurring, so decimal expansion. So that is also a rational number. So next one, 3 by 13. So the decimal expansion of 3 by 13, you have 0.230769 continuous like this. So 0.230769 whole bar. So it has a non-terminating and recurring decimal expansion. So it is non-terminating and recurring decimal expansion. So last one, 4 1 by 8, mixed fraction converted to improper fraction, you get 4 8s 32 plus 1 33 by 8. So this is an improper. So when you divide 33 by 8 you get 4.125. The decimal expansion of 33 by 8 you get 4.125 and it is terminating. There is no place after 125. So it has a terminating decimal expansion. It is also a rational number. Okay, next, you know that 1 by 7 is equal to 0.142857 bar. So 1 by 7 is equal to 0.142857 bar. Can you predict what decimal expansion of 2 by 7, 3 by 7, 4 by 7, 5 by 7, 6 by 7 without actual doing the long division? So, okay. So, you know that 1 by 7. So, 1 by 7. The decimal expansion of 1 by 7 I do like this. So, 0.142857 they given. So, when I do this one, so you get the reminder 3 first one. So, you take it 30. So, 4's a 28. So, like this it is continuous. So, the 142857, that is one more time repeats. You see that in the first set, the first it is a reminder 1. The first case it is a reminder 1. So, that is 1 by 7. So, next 3. So, 3 by 7, the decimal after decimal you starts with 0.428571. So, 0.428571. The next one is 2. 2 means you have to start with 28 after 2 place. 285714. So, like that 6. So, 85.857142. So, 4. 4 means 57.571428. The lastly 5. So, 5 by 7, the 0.714285. So, you have to write in the order the same one. So, this is a method for this answer. So, next one, express the following in the form P by Q, where P and Q are integers and Q not equal to 0. So, let X is equal to 0.6 bar. So, 0.6 bar means 0.6666. So, that is continuously repeating. So, equation 1, you take it as the equation 1. So, equation 1 into 10 we get. So, when it is multiplied with 10, so you get 10x. So, into 10, 0.666. When you multiply with 10, the decimal will shift to this side. So, you get 6.666. Subtracting 2 from 1. So, you get this is the 2 equation 2. So, subtracting 2 from 1. So, 10x you get 6.666. So on. So, equation 1 you have x equal to 0.6666. So on. So, subtracting means you have to cancel. So, 10x minus x you get 9x. And when you subtracting this one you get 6.000. That means 6 only. 9x is equal to 6. So, x is equal to 6 by 9. So, the common table is 3. 3 2's are 3 3's are. So, the answer is x is equal to 2 by 3. So, what is the value of x? You take it as 0.6 bar is equal to 2 by 3. So, there this is the P by Q form of the question, 0.6 bar. So, next one, 0.47 bar. So, let x is equal to 0.47 bar is equal to 0.4777. Repeat. So, this is take it as equation 1. So, equation 1 into 10, you know that 10x. So, point shift here to here. So, 4.777. So, that is you call it as equation 2. So, you see that 10x is equal to 4.777. So on. And here x is equal to you get 0.477. So on. So, finally you get 9x is equal to 0.07 minus 4 you get 3. So, 4.3 x is equal to 4.3 by 9. So, is in the form of P by Q. Is in the form of P by Q. So, the value of x is equal to 0.47 bar. So, that is equal to 4.3 by 9. So, this is the answer. So, if you want the whole number, so into 10 by 10, so 43 by 90 you get the answer. So, next one, 0.01 bar. So, 0.01 bar. So, let x is equal to 0.01 bar. So, that means 0.00100100100001 continuously repeating. So, equation 1 into 100. Equation 1 into 1000. Why it is 1000 means you have decimal after 3 places and the dash is for 3 places. So, in the first two problems, the dash is for only one place. You see that. So you have to multiply with 10. So multiply with 10. So if the dash is for the recurring is takes place for two places, then you have to multiply for into 100. So you see that. So when it is multiplied with 1000, we get, so 1000x into 1000. So 0.001001001, so on. So when you multiply with 1000, the decimal place shift here to here to here. So 1.001001, that is continuously repeating. So when you subtracting 2 from 1 equation, 2 from 1, the equation 1 you have equation 2, okay, 1000x is equal to 1.001001, so on. So x is equal to 0.001001. So when you subtracting, so you get 999x and 1. So x is equal to 1 by 999. So you get the value 1 by 999. So 0.01 whole bar equal to 1 by 999. So express 0.999, so on, in the form of P by Q, in the form of P by Q, are you surprised by your answer? With your teacher and classmates, discuss why the answer makes sense. Okay, first one. So you know that in the number line, you see that. So this is a number line. So this is 0. 1, 2, so this is 1, 2, so 0.9 is almost here, so it is almost near to 1, so 0.9, it is almost near to 1, so I will expand 0 and 1, so this is 0, so this is 1, so this is 0 and 1, so here it is a 0.9, so okay, here, so this is a 0.9, so 0.99 means it is, one more time you have to divide it into, so this is 1. So now I'll expand 0.9 and 1, 0.9, so this is 0.9, so 0.9 and 1, so this is a 1, so you have 0.91, 0.92, 0.93, 0.94, 0.95, so almost here now 0.99, so 0.99, so one more time this is divided into 10 place and this is the last one, so that is almost near to 1 now, so we have to prove using this one. So let x is equal to 0.9999, so on. So this is equation 1. So let 1 into 10. So this means 0.9 bar. So equation 1 into 10, you get 10x equal to 9.999. So this is equation 2. Subtracting 2 minus 1. So second equation, you have 10x, 9.999. So and x is equal to 0.999. So when you subtracting, you get 9x and you get 9. So x is equal to 9 by 9. So 9 ones are x is equal to 1. So this is the answer. So that means 0.9999, so on, it is reaches to 1. So 0.999, so on, it is equal to 1. Okay, next, find three different irrational number between rational numbers 5 by 7 and 9 by 11. So we have to find three different irrational number between rational number. So these two are rational number, you finding irrational numbers. So the decimal expansion of 5 by 7 and 9 by 11, they given 0.71. So the decimal expansion of 5 by 7, you get 0.7142857, so that repeats one more time like this only. So and the decimal expansion of 9 by 11, you get 0.818, so on. So I write one more time, the 0.714285 bar, so that is the repetition place. So 9 by 11, you get 0.818181, like this. So the irrational number between 5 by 7 and 9 by 11, so it should be non-terminating and non-repeating. So that is the characteristic of irrational number. So one, it is non-terminating and non-repeating. So we only form that number. So 0. So after 71, you have 72. So and in between 81. So 720, 720, 720, 740, 740, like this. If you take, so this is a irrational number. So like this, you take one more and you take one more 80, 800, 800, 800, 4 times. So this is how you find the three different rational numbers between rational number 5 by 7 and 9 by 11. Okay, next, classify the following numbers as a rational and irrational, rational number or irrational number. So okay, first one, root 23, it is an irrational number since root 23, it is not a perfect square. So in the place of root 23 you have root 16. So root 16, you know that it is the value 4. The value of root 16 you have 4. This is the perfect square and the 4 is belongs to rational number. So root 23, so 23 is a prime number and it is an irrational number. It is like root 2, root 3. So you know that root 2, root 3 are irrational number. So next, root 2 to 5, it is a perfect square. So 2 to 5 you get a 15. So 15 is a whole number or a rational number. So therefore it is a rational number. So you know that 15 can written in the form of P by Q. 15 can written as 15 by 1. So 0.3796, it is an irrational number since it is a terminating decimal expansion. It is a terminating decimal expansion. 0.7.478478. So it is a rational since it is terminating. So it is terminating, sorry. So it is terminating and repeating decimal expansion. So next, 0.10100000 3 times. It is an irrational since it has a non-terminating. You know that it is a non-terminating. There is no stop and a non-repeating. So there is no repetition also. 10. So 1 after 2 0, 1 after 3 0s. So therefore it is an irrational number. Okay. 3.765 on the number line using successive magnification. Okay, so first you draw one number line, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so on, and minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, minus 6. So this is a positive integers, so this one is a negative integers. So the first one, 3.625. So clearly you know that the 3.765 is lies between 3 and 4. So it is more than 3 and is less than 4. So the, it is lies between 3 and 4. So I magnifies 3 and 4 in the second number line. So now it is in the in between 3 and 4. So first 3, next 3.1, 3.2, 3.3, 3.4, 3.5, 3.6. So 3.7, so here it is 3.7. So in between 3.7 and 3.8 it is. 3.7 and 3.8. So now you magnify 3.7 and 3.8 in the next number line. So I take 3.7 and 3.8, in between you have 9, 10 readings. So 3.71, 3.72, 73, 74, 75, 76, 77, 78, 79. So you want 3.765. So it is lies between 3.76 and 3.77. So you have to expand or magnify 3.76 and 3.77. So in between 3.76 and 3.77 you have 10 digits. So you have to mention like the 3.76 and 3.78. So it starts with 3.761, 762, 0.763, 0.764. So you want the answer 3.765. Is it here? So this is the answer. So next one more time. So usualize 4.6 bar. So usualize 4.6 bar on the number line up to 4 decimal places. We have to give up to 4 decimal places. So 0.4626 bar means 4.262626, like this it repeats. You take only 4 digits. You take only 4 digits. So clearly the 4.26 is lies between 4 and 5. The 4 and 5. So 4.1, 4.2, 4.3, 4.4, 4.5, 4.6, 4.7, 4.8, 4.9. So the reading 4.26, it is lies between 4.2 and 4.3. So now you magnify 4.2 and 4.3, you get 4.2, 4.21, 4.22, 4.23, 4.24, 4.25, 4.26, 4.27, 4.28, 4.29, 4.3. So it is lies between 4.26 and 4.27. So 4.26 you have 4.27 you magnify. So you get like this. So one more time, it is like this. So answer is 4.2626. So this is the 4.26 bar on the number line up to 4 decimal places. So next, so operation on real numbers. So operations on real numbers. Check whether 7 by root 5, 7 by root 5, comma root 2 plus 21, pi minus 2 are irrational number or not. So we have to prove that. So is it irrational number or not? So you know that root 5 is irrational, therefore 7 into root 5 is also irrational, 7 by root 5 is also irrational, root 2 plus 21 is also irrational, pi is irrational, so pi minus 2 is also irrational. We know that, I given that same sentence. So root 5 is the value. The decimal expansion of root 5 is 2.236 and root 2 you get 1.4142. So the value of pi is 3.1415 are irrational numbers. Therefore 7 root 5, 7 by root 5 are also irrational numbers. Note, so the reasons here, the sum or difference of a rational and an irrational number. If you made a sum, so this is a sum or the difference of a rational. One is rational, so this is a rational, so this is irrational. So this is a rational, so this is irrational. The sum or a difference of a rational and an irrational. So one is rational, one is an irrational number is always irrational. So this is a irrational number. The product and the quotient. So product and the quotient. So quotient is a division. So the product and quotient of a non-zero rational and a irrational number. So non-zero rational and an irrational number is always irrational. So that is also a irrational in a multiplication, in division, addition, subtraction. So if it is you have one irrational number, the whole number itself is a irrational number. So first you have addition in that. So 2 root 2 plus 5 root 3 and root 2 minus 3 root 3. So 2 root 2 plus 5 root 3 addition, root 2 minus 3 root 3. So you take root 2 root 2. So you treat like x in the algebra. So 2 root 2 root 2. So you get 2 root 2. So this is, take it as 1 root 2. So you have no number means you take it as 1 root 2. 2 plus 1 you have 3 root 2. 5 minus 3 you have 2 root 3. So 5 minus 3 you have 2 root 3. So 3 root 2 plus 2 root 3. So like this, very simple. So multiplication, I see it here. So 6 root 5 into 2 root 5. So 6 into 2, root 5 into root 5. Root 5, root 5, it is 5. So always root 5, root 5. So the value of root is, so 5 power half. So the value of root is always power half. Power half. You have 5 power half into 5 power half. So 5 power half plus half. You get 5 power 1. So that is a 5. So like this. Okay. So understood? Okay. Next. Divide 8 root 15 by 2 root 3. So 8 root 15 by 2 root 3. So 8 root 15 divided by 2 root 3. So root 15 can written as root 3 root 5. So root 15 can written as root 3 into root 5. So root 3 cancels. So 2 1s are 2 4s are 8. So 4 root 5. So next. So identities. We have some identities. So already you studied this type of identities. Root AB equal to root A into root B. Root AB equal to root A into root B. So next. So that means root 25 if you have. So you can write root 5 into root 5. So root 25 is 5. So root cancels. So this is also a 5. Okay. So root 25 can written as root 5 into 5. Root 5 into root 5. So root a by b, you can root a by root b. You can write like this. So root a plus root b, root a minus root b equal to a minus b. So this is the same as a plus b, a minus b identity. A square minus b square. It is almost same like this. But you have a root. So you get root a whole square, root b whole square. So this is very simple. So root a plus root b into root a minus root b is equal to a minus b. How it is means? So in the place of root a, you have, in the place of a, you have root a whole square minus root b whole square. So root to root get cancelled, you get a minus b, a minus b. So in that case, so a plus root b, a minus root b is equal to a square minus b. So this is also a, in the like this, a plus b, a minus b, like this identity, a plus b, a minus b equal to a square minus b square. So you have identity in algebra, a plus b into a minus b equal to a square minus b square. This is almost same, these two. So next, root a plus root b into root c plus root d. So you have to multiply like this, root a to root c. So root a to root d, root b to root c, root b to root d. So root ac, root ad, root bc, root bd. So plus 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 plus. Okay, root ac plus root ad plus root bc plus root bd. So next, root a plus root b whole square. So this is in the form of a plus b whole square equal to a square plus b square plus 2ab. So you get root a whole square plus root b whole square plus 2 root a root b. So root a root square cancels, you get a. Root square cancels, you get b plus 2 root ab. So this is the answer. So almost same, this one and this one. So is it like this? This is come from this identity. Okay, next, simplify each of the following expressions. Simplify each of the following expression. So 3 plus root 3 into 2 plus root 2. So 3 plus root 3 into 2 plus root 2. So you take the question, 3 plus root 3, 2 plus root 2. So multiply 3 to this one and root 3 to this one. Okay, like this, 3 to. Okay, so I take like this only one more time. So 3 2s are 6, 3 root 2, 2 root 3 and root 2 into root 2. Okay, so 6, 3 root 2, 2 root 3, root 3 into root 6, root 2, you get root 6, very simple. So this is the answer. So next, 3 plus root 3, 3 minus root 3. So this is in the form of a plus b, a minus b equal to a square minus b square. So a plus b, a minus b. So a square, 3 square minus root 3 whole square. In the place of b, you have 3 square. So square and square root get cancelled, you get 9 minus 3, you get 6. So next, root 5 plus root 2 whole square. So is in the form of a plus b whole square. So a plus b whole square equal to a square plus b square plus 2ab. So this is an identity. So root 5 plus root 2 whole square. So this is the question. So in the place of a, you have root 5. In the place of b, you have root 2. So root 5 square root 2 square plus 2ab means root 5 root 2. So square and square root cancels, 5. Square and square root get cancels, 2. So 2 root 5 into 2. So root 10. So 5 plus 2, you get 7. So 5 plus 2, you get 7. So 2 root 10. So 7 plus 2 root 10. You can't add 7 plus 2, 9. So this is always two different groups. Okay. This is two are unlike words. So this is 7. So this is 2 root 10. So like 2x. 2x. You can't add 7 and 2x, no? So like this, 2 plus 2 root 10. Okay. So root 5 minus root 2, root 5 plus root 2. You have to use one more identity. a plus b a minus b is equal to a square minus b square. A plus b a minus b is equal to a square minus b square. You have to study the identity first. So root 5 in the place of a, you have root 5 in the place of b, root 2. So root 5 minus root 2, a square minus b square. So root 5 whole square, square root and square get cancelled, square root and square, 5 minus 2 you get 3. Okay, so next, the rationalize the denominator of the following. So rationalize the denominator. So this is very important. So rationalization is very, very important. There are two methods. Okay, so first one, 1 by root 7, you take 1 by root 7. So multiply and divided by root 7. So multiply and divided by root 7. So you get root 7 into root 7. You get root 7 into root 7 is nothing but root 7 square in the denominator. So square and square root get cancelled. You get the 7 here. So I show it. This is a denominator. What I am showing now, denominator, root 7 into root 7 is the root 7 whole square. Square root and square get cancelled. So you get 7. So root 7 in the numerator as it is. So root 7 by 7. So next, 1 by root 7 minus root 6. So 1 by root 7 minus root 6. So 1 by root 7 minus root 6, you take it one. Then multiply with root 7 plus root 6. So if it is minus is there, then you take plus. Suppose it is plus is there, you take a minus here. So we have to multiply and divided by root 7 plus 6, root 6, root 7 plus root 6. Okay. So you get the numerator is the same as a root 7 plus root 6. So is in the form of a plus b into a minus b. So a plus b into a minus b. So you write a square minus b square. So a square. So root 7 whole square minus b square root 6 whole square. Square and square root get cancelled. Square and square root get cancelled. You get 7 minus 6. So 7 minus 6 is equal to 1. So you can't write. So root 7 minus root 6 is the answer. So next, 5 divided by root 3 minus root 5. So 5 divided by root 3 minus root 5. Okay. So you write 5 divided by root 3 minus root 5. So if it is minus, you have to take it plus. So multiply and divided by root 3 plus root 5. Okay. So 5 into root 3 plus root 5. So this is in the form of a square, a plus b, a minus b. So you write a square minus b square. So that means root 3 whole square minus root 5 whole square. So square root and square get cancelled. Square root and square get cancelled. So 3 minus 5, you get minus 2 in the denominator. So you take 3 minus 5 minus 2. 5 minus 2 you take outside. So root 3 plus root 5. So next, 1 by root 7 minus 2, same like this. You have a negative here, you take it plus. So multiply and divided by root 7 plus 2. So you get root 7 plus 2. So this is a root 7 whole square minus 2 square. So root square 7 whole square is square root and square get cancelled. You get 7. 2 square is 4. You get the answer in the denominator is 3. So 7 minus 4 you get 3. So the numerator as it is as a root 7 plus 2. Okay. So next, loss of exponent for a real numbers. Let a greater than 0 be a real number and p and q be a rational numbers. Then we have a power p into a power q is equal to a power p plus q. So take an example. So you have 2 power 3 into 2 power 2. So 2 like a and a. So 2 power 3 into 2 power 2, you get 2 power 3 plus 2. So that means 2 power 5. So 2 power 3 means 2 into 2 into 2, 3 times, 2 into 2, 2 times. So totally 2 power 5. So 2 power 5 equal to 2 power 5. So LHS equal to RHS. And here, second one, a power p whole power q is equal to a power p into q. So the power multiplication, a power pq. So see that 2 power 2 whole power 3, so 2 power 2 whole power 3 is 2 power 6, 2 power 6, that means 2 power 2 3 times, 2 power 2, 2 power 2, so 2 power 6, so 2 power 2 2 times, 2 times, 2 times, 6 times, that means 2 power 6 into 2 power 6, so LHS equal to RHS, so this statement is correct. So next, a power p divided by a power q, you get a power p minus q. So give an example and you practice yourself. So last one, a power p into b power p equal to ab power p. A power p, so that means 2 power 3 and 3 power 3. So that means 2 3 is a 6 power 3. 6 power 3. Okay, next. So this is very important. A power m by n equal to, so nth root of a power, so nth root of a whole power m, so nth root of a whole power m is equal to nth root of a m. So one type, nth root of a whole power m also you write, or nth root of a power m. So take an example, 2 power 2 by 3, so 2 power 2 by 3, so that means, so cubed root of, so divided will come to the root, the cubed root of 2 square, or the cubed root of 2 whole square. So one more example I given, 2 power 3 by 2, so that is the square root of 2 cube, or the square root of 2 whole cube. The square root of 2 whole cube. So this is the two types. So next, find 7 square into 7 power 5, or 7 power 2 into 7 power 5. So is in the form of a power m into a power n is equal to a power m plus n. So 17 power 2 plus 5, you get 17 power 7. So next, a power p whole power q, so a power pq, so that means 2 into minus 7, you get minus 14. So next, 23 power 10, 23 divided by 23 by 7, 23 power 7, so a power p divided by a power q, so you can written as a power p minus q, so that is 10 minus 7, you get 3. Okay, next. 2 power 2 by 3 into 2 power 1 by 3. So a power p into a power q is equal to a power p plus q. So 2 by 3 plus 1 by 3. So fraction addition, you have common denominator here. So right, then you have to add numerator 2 plus 1, 3 by 3. So denominator as it is 3 by 3. So 3 ones are, you get 2 power 1. So that is equal to 2. So the value of 2 by 3 into 2. 1 by 3 you get 2. Okay, next, find the 64 power half. So 64 can written as 8 into 8. Suppose you factorize 2, 3 is a 6, 2 2s are 4, 2 1s are, 2 6 are, 2 8s are, 2 4s are, 2 2s are, 2 1s are. So total you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. So 2 into 2 into 2, 6 times. So that means, so these 3, 2, 2, 2, 8 into 8. So 2 2s are 4, 4 2s are 8, 2 2s are 4, 4 2s are 8. So 64 can written as 8 into 8. Power half, so 8 can written as 8 into 8 is 8 square, you know that, so whole power half, so a power m whole power n, so you can written as a power m into n, so a power m whole power n can written as a power m into n, so 2 and half get cancels, so you get the answer 8. So next, 32 1 by 5, 32 can write like this, 32 2 1s are 12, 2 6s are 12, 2 8s are, 2 4s are, 2 2s are, two ones. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So you write like 2 into 2 into 2 into 5 times, whole power 1/5. So that means 2 power 5 whole power 1/5. So a power m whole power n equal to a power m into n. So 5 and 1/5 get cancels. You get 2. Okay, next 125 whole power 1/3. 125 whole power 1/3. So 125 can written as 5 into 5. 25 into 5. 125. So whole power 1/3. So 5 into 5 into 5 you can written as 5 power 3. 1/3. So 3 and 1/3 get cancels. So a power m whole power n you can written as a power m into n. So 3 and 3 get cancels. The answer 5. So 9 power 3/2. So 9 can written as 3 into 3. So 3 square. So a power m whole power n. So a power m into n. So 2 and 2 get cancels. So the remaining 3 power 3. 3 power 3 means 3 into 3 into 3, 27. So like this, you continue. Okay, next one more problem. 32 power 2/5. 32 power 2 by 5. 32. So you can write as 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2, 5 times. So 32, 2 2s are 4, 4 2s are 8, 8 2s are 16, 16 2s are 32, whole power 2/5. So 5 and 5 get cancels in here. Okay, a power m whole power n is equal to a power m into n, a power m into n. So a power m whole power n, so this is the formula, a power m whole power n can written as a power m into n. Okay, 2 square, you get the answer 4. 16 3/4. 16 can written as 2 into 2 into 2 into 4 times. So 3/4. Okay. So 2 into 2, 4 times means 2 power 4 whole power 3/4. So 4 and 4 get cancelled. A power m whole power n can written as a power m into n. So 2 power 3. So 2 power 3 means 2 into 2 into 2. 2 to the 4, 4 to the 8. So like that 125. So in the minus. 125 power minus 1/3. So we have, when you remove the minus from the power, so we have to just reciprocal. So 1 by 125 1 by 3. So 1 by 125 1 by 3, then we have to remove this minus sign. Okay, so 125 can written as 5 into 5 25 25 into 5 125. So 125 can written as 5 into 5 into 5, 1/3. So 5 power 3 into 1/3, 3 get cancels. So 3 and 1/3 get cancels. So that is 1/5. So next 2 2/3 into 2 1/5. So a power m into a power n. So a power m plus n. So common denominator you have 15. 3 5s are 15. 5 3s are. So 2 5s are 10. 1 3 is a 3. So 10 plus 3 13 by 15 answer. So the answer is 2 power 13 by 5. So next 1 by 3 power 3 whole power 7. 1 by 3 power 3 whole power 7. So when it is denominator, the power is in positive, it is go to numerator, then it is negative. So I shift this whole place to numerator, then it is 3 power minus 3. So 3 power minus 3 whole power 7. So a power m whole power n can written as a power m into n. So minus 3 into 7 you get minus 21. So that is the answer. So 3 power minus 21. So next 11 power half divided by 11 power 1/4. So a power p divided by a power q. So a power p minus q. 1/2 minus 1/4. So half minus 1/4, you know that it is 1/4 only. So half minus 1/4 is 1/4 only. So common denominator is 4. So 2 2s are, so you get 2 here, minus 1. So 2 minus 1 is 1/4. So that is 11 1/4. So lastly 7 power half into 8 power 1/2. 7 power 1/2 into 8 power 1/2, you get So the 7 half is a common you take outside. So 7 into 8, 56 power half. So that is equal to square root of 56. So that means square root of 7. So 7 power half is square root of 7. So 8 power half is square root of 8 equal to square root of 56. So 7 8s are 56. You can write like this also. Thank you.